हरे कृष्ण डिवोटीज सन्मत प्रणाम जय श्रील प्रभुपाद प्लीज एक्सेप्ट माय हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस सो वी विल कंटिन्यू द डे टू ऑफ गोवर्धन परिक्रमा टुडे आई एम होपिंग दैट वी विल बी एबल टू फिनिश मे गो अ फ्यू मिनट्स ओवर इन ऑर्डर टू फिनिश सो आई विल स्टार्ट विद सम मंगलाचरण प्रेयर्स ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानंजना शलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदामयं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमति भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद जय श्री अद्वैत गदाधरा श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंदा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे हरे बोल ओके सो We'll start our parikrama from where we left off yesterday. Give me one. Can you all see my screen?
Yes, Mataji, we are able to see it.
So, as you know, we started our parikrama from Mansi Ganga, right? And on the shore of Mansi Ganga, we discussed the pastime of Mansi Ganga, that it is non-different from Mother Ganga. And we saw some places on the shore of Mansi Ganga. This was the boating pastime, Naukavihar Leela. This is Mukharavind, Chakleshwar Mahadev Temple, Chakratirtha, Haridev Temple, Sanatan Goswami's Bhajan Kutir. This is Sanatan Goswami. Praying to Madan Mohan and he was given the Shila. Dan Ghati Mandir or Dan Ghati where the tax collector pastimes happen. This is the temple. Anur village, this is Bhakti Vedanta Ashram or Iskon Govardhan. And Dan Nivartan Kund where the tax was taken back, where gopis were able to get back at Krishna for taking the tax. So this is where we had stopped. So we'll go forward from here. So the next place after this that is important for especially for Gaudiya Vaishnavas is Gopal Prakatasthali. So this is the temple on the right side and this is the deity. So actually this deity of Gopalji, also known as Srinathji, is the deity that is currently in the Nath Dwara in Rajasthan. You must have heard of that temple. That temple is very, very famous. Actually, it is the second richest temple after Balaji in Tirupati. So after Balaji, Nath Dwara of Rajasthan is considered the second richest temple, and this is the deity of Srinathji. So this deity, or Gopalji deity or Srinathji deity, manifested in this place. This is the place called Gopal Prakat Sthali. How did Gopalji manifested here? This is a very beautiful story. Those of you who know Madhvendrapuri, right? Madhvendrapuri is the spiritual master of Nityanand Prabhu, Ishwarapuri, and you know that Ishwarapuri is spiritual master of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Madhvendrapuri is a very important acharya in our line. And when he came to Vrindavan, so this is about this is many, many years before Mahaprabhu. This is about 100 years before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Vrindavan. So when Madhvendrapuri came here, he was staying at Govindkund, which will come next. After this one will come Govindkund. But that's where he was staying. And in this place of Gopal Prakat Sthali here, he was doing bhajan. He was not eating, not drinking. He was just completely immersed in his Krishna consciousness, completely in the, you know, very ecstatic at being in Govardhan. So at that time, a boy came to him, a little cowherd boy came to him and he gave him some milk. He said, you know, this is my area. In this area, I supply milk and sweets and other food items to all the people that live here and nobody goes hungry or thirsty. How come what kind of bhajan are you doing? Such an intense bhajan that you have not eaten or drunk anything. Let me give you some milk. And he gave him very, very nectarian sweet milk that Madhvendra Puri drank. And the boy said, just finish your milk. I will come later and we'll talk more. And boy left. At that time, Madhvendra Puri cleaned the pot, drank the milk and fell asleep. And he was just waiting for the boy to come again. The next day, the boy came again and he said, you know, Madhvendra Puri, I was waiting for you to come for ages actually. I want to show you something. Come with me. And he took him to this these bushes in this place. There were some bushes. He took them there and he said, I've been laying here for many, many years, ever since that fanatic Muslim ruler Aurangzeb attacked Vrindavan and Govardhan and destroyed so many temples and destroyed so many deities. I was discarded here. There was a Brahman who used to take care of me. He actually hid me here. And so I've been staying here for many, many years. And now you take me and install me somewhere. And please, you take care of me. So that was the deity of this. This was the deity that he, Madhvendra Puri, found in the bushes. This is the famous deity of Srinathji at the Nathdwara temple. And so at that place, Madhvendra Puri actually took great care of this deity he was serving. In this place, and not in this place, there is a separate place where he was serving. This is just the Prakat Stali, but he built a temple for Gopalji and he was serving. And then the successive line goes down that after Madhvendra Puri left Vrindavan, he gave the care of Srinathji to two other Brahmins. Then those Brahmins gave his service to Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami actually gave the service to Sri Vallabhacharya's son Vitthal. So in this way, the deity was handed off from one after another great people, and finally it was taken to Rajasthan. So this is that very famous place. And then we'll go to the next place. This is Govind Kund. This is a little temple in the Govind Kund. This is the beautiful Govind Kund. So Govind Kund has very beautiful story also. The way Govind Kund was formed, it's, you know, the story is very glorious. Basically, after Lord Indra had offended Krishna so much, he was very, very remorseful, very, very regretful of what he had done. So he came with Surbi Kao and with his elephant Aravat to offer prayers and apologies to Krishna. At that time, they all did Abhishek for Krishna. So so Lord Indra actually called the celestial Ganges, like, you know, the Akash Ganga. Akash Ganga ko bulaya, and with that water, they did Abhishek of Krishna. And Surbi cows did Abhishek with the milk. So Govind Kund is formed from that Abhishek water of Krishna, from the Akash Ganga and milk of Surbi cows. So this is a very, very glorious place. And this is the place where Madhvendra Puri was also meditating when he came to Govardhan. This is the history written here of Govind Kund, that how Parajit Hokar Indra Shri Krishna ki Sharan mein aaye aur Kam Dhenu ke Dhoot se Shri Krishna ka Abhishek kiya. So this is, it is given, the whole history is given. And many, many acharyas, many, many other sadhus have spent so much time at Govind Kund. They take a dip in the Govind Kund, and some people, we took some water from Mansi Ganga, Govind Kund, Radha Kund, everywhere that we could to use for our Achman. This is Apsara Kund. Apsara Kund is also nearby Govind Kund. Apsara Kund is basically also when Lord Indra was offering apologies, some Apsaras from heaven, from Swarg Lok, seven Apsaras came, and they also did Abhishek of Krishna. And that Abhishek water made Apsara Kund. So this is another place that comes next. Punchari ka Lota. So Punchari, so remember yesterday we talked about how Govardhan is shaped like peacock, or Mayur ki shape ka hai Govardhan. So this place, we started from, remember, the mouth of Govardhan, and now we have reached the poonch, or the tail of Govardhan. So this is the poonch of the Govardhan, Punchari. And this is Lota Baba. So who's Lota? Again, very sweet story of Lota. He was a friend of Krishna. So when Akrura came to take Krishna and Balram to Mathura, this Lota had cooked some food for Krishna. He used to cook some food for Krishna, and he would offer him various sweets and milk and water. And that day also he had cooked some food for Krishna. And when Krishna and Balram were leaving, this Lotha ran up to them and he asked Krishna, when will you come back? I have made some food for you. So please come back so we can eat together. So at that time, Krishna said, I'll come back day after tomorrow. I'll come back in 1 to 2 days. So Lotha said, okay, I will sit here and wait and I will not eat or drink anything until you come back. So in this way, Krishna left, but he never came back. So the Lotha, who is Krishna's friend, is still sitting there. And this is his deity in this temple called Punchari Kalota. So Punchari is the poonch of Govardhan and Lotha Baba is the Krishna's friend who's still waiting there for Krishna to return. So such sweet, wonderful pastimes have happened on Govardhan that they're just completely amazing. They blow your mind to think how what kind of sweet exchanges Krishna had with his friends. This is Manikandali Cave. This is the next place. The cave is now closed, but Manikandali Cave is famous because one of our this cave is located in a forest called Sutalvan Forest, and this is famous because a few of our acharyas from Gaudiya Sampradaya have done their bhajan and have had darshan of Krishna in this cave. So one of the great personality who was a very close associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that did bhajan here was Raghav Pandit. Some of you are familiar with the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would know Raghav Pandit. Raghav Pandit is also has a very famous pastime with Nityanand Prabhu when they did his abhishek. So Raghav Pandit did a lot of bhajan in this cave, and he knew like a lot of places of pastimes of Krishna from Braja. He's supposed to be the Champaklata Sakhi from Krishna Leela. And two other acharyas that spent some time here in this cave are Srinivas Pandit and Narottam Das Thakur. Srinivas Acharya and Narottam Das Thakur, yes. So both of them actually one day when they were doing bhajan in this cave, they got darshan of Krishna and after that they fainted in ecstasy. And next day again a coward boy came and woke them and said, but why did I came to see you, why did you faint? So they also got the Krishna darshan like that. So this is that Manikandali cave in the Sutalvan forest, also Raghav Pandit's bhajan kutir basically. Next comes Kadamban. So you know that there are many, many forests, right, on Govardhan. So one was Sutalvan that we just saw, and this is Kadamban. And Kadam trees are very popularized in various types of poetry. I know some of our parents and all know the poetry where people have glorified Krishna sitting playing his flute under the Kadam Vrikshas. So this is the Kadam one. And in this Kadam one are three very important kunds. Three important kunds. I'll show you those one after another. This is Indra Kund. So Indra Kund is when Indra came to do the Abhishek of Krishna and he took shelter of Surbhi cow to offer his apologies. At that time, Indra was very, very regretful of what he had done, how much offense he had caused, Vishnu Aparadh he had done. And so he cried so much that his tears made this kund called Indra Kund. So that is the kund made from his tears, Indra Kund. And the other kund, that so three main kunds that come here is Indra Kund, Surbhi Kund and Airavat Kund. Surbhi Kund is the milk. Well, Surbhi Kund is the place where Surbhi cow had Indra apologize to Krishna. It was only under the instructions of Surbhi cow that Indra was able to apologize to Krishna. In Bhagavatam, or in, let me see, I think in, yes, Krishna book, chapter 27, the prayers offered by Surbhi cow are given in detail. She offers very, very beautiful prayers to Lord Krishna has Indra forgiven by Lord Sri Krishna. So she basically helps to ask the mercy of Lord Krishna for Indra. So this is that place, Surbhi Kund. Similarly, there is Airavat Kund also. Then the next place that comes is Uddhav Kund. So if you remember yesterday, we talked about Sri Uddhavji being one of the Haridas. You remember we talked about three Haridas. One Haridas in Srimad Bhagavatam is Yudhishthir Maharaj. Another Haridas was Sri Uddhavji. And the third Haridas and the best of all Haridas, Haridas Varya, is Giri Govardhan. So Uddhavji also spent some time on Govardhan when he came to Vrindavan to meet with Gopis and Nand Maharaj and Yashoda Maya, right? So the story that behind Uddhav Kund is that when Uddhav came to Vrindavan, he saw the amazing, you know, most wonderful devotional service of Gopis. He saw their top mellows in which they were serving Krishna, their topmost bhav that was difficult to achieve by anybody. So, and Uddhav himself was a very, very close associate of Krishna in Dwarka, right? He's a cousin of Krishna, he's a very, very intimate associate of Krishna in Dwarka. But when he saw Gopi's bhav, he was so mesmerized that he thought, my devotion is nothing compared to their devotion. So he thought, I should ask for the dust of their lotus feet, dust of the lotus feet of the gopis. But he thought it wouldn't look good because the gopis are simple cowherd girls, cowherd maidens. And if I ask them for their dust, then I'm such a big kshatriya. I'm like this strong, so powerful kshatriya who's serving Krishna in Dwarka, and I'm asking for the dust of the feet of these simple cowherd girls. So this will not look good. So he thought the best way to get their dust is if I could become like a clump of grass in the forests of Vrindavan, so that when gopis will walk on that grass, I will automatically get their dust. So this is the place where he prayed very intensely to become a clump of grass in Brajbhumi. So that is the place of Uddhav Kund. And these prayers, let me see where they come. I'm sure they come somewhere in Bhagavatam. Yes, I'm not sure, but yeah, these prayers must be some available in Bhagavatam. And so this is that place. And this, and also a lot of these deities, so like this temple on the right side you see has the deity of Uddhavji. These deities were installed by Vajranab, who was the great grandson of Krishna. And a lot of the deities and temples were destroyed when Muslims, especially Aurangzeb, invaded Vrindavan and tried to destroy all the temples and deities. So a lot of the deities were relocated, but a lot of deities were manifested actually by Sri Vajranab, who is the great grandson of Krishna. And he used, he actually talked to his mother Uttara about various, he talked to Uttara about various, you know, people's identity, like what does Uddhavji look like, what did Krishna look like, and are these deities in resemblance to those people or not. So a lot of those deities are made by Vajranam, installed by him. So this is the next place. And this is a place called Mallyahari Kunda. So Mallyahari Kunda is a place where a very sweet pastime happens. It's called the pearl pastime. You see on the top, it says site of Radha and Krishna's pearl pastime. So let me see what time. Okay, we have some time. So I'll tell you that story. The pearl pastime is a story where Krishna... So this is a story where Krishna saw that gopis, in this place, gopis used to make pearl necklaces. So they'll string pearl on the thread and make very beautiful pearl necklaces. And Krishna asked the gopis to give them, give him some of the pearls, but they refused to do. He said, I want them for my cows, two of my cows. I want to decorate them with these pearls. But the gopi said, you know, these pearls are not meant for your cows. So then he said, okay, then I'll grow my own pearls. So he went home and he asked Mother Yashoda to give him some pearls. He said, I'll grow them. I'll plant them in the earth and I will grow them. So Mother Yashoda was very tickled by this, but she regardless gave him the pearls. and he planted them in the earth, and they did grow and produce very, very big, beautiful pearls. Pure pearls, as I grow, gaye, plants ban gaye pearls ke. And so he took those pearls to make the pearl necklaces. When gopis saw this, they thought, okay, we can also grow them. So they also planted their own pearls. But unke pearls se kuch nahi bana, there was no plant. So they asked Krishna, you know, can you give us some of your pearls? He said, yes, I can give you some of my pearls, but you have to give me some offering. So then they made some sweets and betel nuts just flower garlands for him, and he made many pearl necklaces and put them each in a golden box and delivered it to each gopi at Radharani. So this is a place called Mallahari Kunda where that pearl pastime happens. This is that place. Okay, then we'll go to the next place, and this is the most glorious Shyam Kund. So now we've reached Shyam Kund and Radha Kund, and you know that Shyam Kund and Radha Kund are adjacent to each other. This is Radha Kund. So this is again Radha Kund. So Radha Kund, you know, I can talk about Radha Kund for a long time. Radha Kund, as you understand, is the topmost holiest place. Most of you are already familiar, so I will not go into the glories of Radha Kund here, but I'll just go into the pastime of Radha Kund, how Radha Kund and Shyam Kund had come about. We discussed it a little bit yesterday, that there was a demon Krishna had killed. The demon was called Arishtasur, and he was in the form of a bull. When Krishna killed him, and later on he joined gopis and Radharani for the Ras, they refused him entry into the Ras. They said, you know, you're contaminated, you have committed Gohatya, right? Just similar story to the Mansi Ganga, but this time this was a different demon, Arishtasur. So they said, you know, you need to go to all the pilgrimages and take a dip in waters from different pilgrimages, and then you will be purified. So this was not just Ganga, they wanted him to get purified in, but different pilgrimages from everywhere. So he said, again, same thing, you know, he will not leave Vrindavan, and I will just call all the pilgrimages right here. So he, with the heel of his foot, he hit the ground, he struck the ground, and a big hole appeared in the ground. And in that hole, he prayed and called various pilgrimages to enter into the that hole. That was the Shyam Kund. So various pilgrimages, their personified form came, and they entered into the Shyam Kund. So that was the holy water from many, many different pilgrimages, not just Ganga. And when gopis saw this, then they wanted a kund of their own. They said, we also want a kund. So they, with their bangles, started digging another place nearby, adjacent to Shyam Kund. They started digging a place, a kund, for Radharani. And they dug the kund, they dug the hole in the ground, but now they had no water. So they thought, okay, we will go to Mansi Ganga and get water from there. Mansi Ganga is a little ways away. Mansi Ganga is not very close, and it's not possible to bring so much water to Radha Kund from Mansi Ganga. So they were in a dilemma. And then Krishna said, you know, just take water from my Shyam Kund. I'll give you some water, and you can put that in the Radha Kund. But they refused. They did not want to take water from Shyam Kund. So then all those pilgrimages that had entered into Shyam Kund, they again manifested and prayed to Radharani. They offered her obeisances, and they said, please allow us to serve you, and please give us entry into your kund also. And so she melted, and she accepted the request of taking water from Shyam Kund. So then the water from Shyam Kund was transferred into Radha Kund also, and then manifested the beautiful Radha Kund. So that was the story behind it, and this happened on the day of Bahula Ashtami, which is in Kartik Mas, the very glorious Ashtami Tithi, where Radha Kund and Shyam Kund appeared. So Radha Kund is, you know, very, very high position, in, as Rupa Goswami says in Upadeshamrita, or Nectar of Instruction, that we saw that, you know, above the Vaikuntha planets is better than Vaikuntha planets is Mathura Dham. Better than Mathura Dham is Vrindavan Dham. In Vrindavan Dham, the best place is Giri Govardhan. And in Giri Govardhan, the topmost pilgrimage, the holiest place, the highest spiritual abode is Radha Kund. So at Radha Kund, many, many different pastimes have happened, and many of our great acharyas, they have their bhajan kutis at Radha Kund actually. And this is the bhajan kutir of Raghunath Das Goswami. This is also his samadhi mandir. He had clear view of Radha Kund sitting here. And he did a bhajan on Radha Kund for almost 45 years. He was so attached to Radha Kund. And so many devotees, so many acharyas have prayed that we want Nivas at Radha Kund. So actually so many of our great acharyas like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has their bhajan kutir there. He wrote Chaitanya Charitamrita. That place is also right next to Raghunadas Goswami Samadhi Mandir where Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami wrote the Chaitanya Charitamrita. And then Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's bhajan kutir is also right there. Jeev Goswami's bhajan kutir is right there. And of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the one, you know, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who, because of whom the Radha Kund and Shyam Kund appeared again, because they had become oblivious, they had disappeared to our vision until Mahaprabhu again revealed their sights. So when Mahaprabhu came to Govardhan, there was nothing but paddy fields in this place. And then he did bhajan here. He prayed to have this the place of Radha Kund and Shyam Kund revealed to him. And this was revealed to him, and he started the excavation process. And the excavation and this job was given to Raghunath Das Goswami to finish the excavation of Radha Kund and Shyam Kund. So they were remanifested in this age by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And so there is this place, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has many places in Giri Govardhan where he sat and did his bhajan, where he, and those places are called sitting place, like Mahaprabhu ki baithak. So ye bhi Radha Kund mein bhi Mahaprabhu ki baithak hai. And Mahaprabhu's baithak is also on like Mansi Ganga and other places. I'll show you, I think I have a couple of pictures of Mahaprabhu ki baithak from different places. Similarly, there is Madhvendrapuri ki baithak, Vallabhacharya ki baithak, this Janva Mata ki baithak is on the Radha Kund also. This is again Raghunath Das Goswami Samadhi Mandir. In this Samadhi Mandir, Raghunath Das Goswami Samadhi Mandir, 24-hour kirtan goes on. And actually, if you know, in the last few days of his life, Raghunath Das Goswami will eat nothing but chhach or buttermilk, right? So if you ask the devotees there that are doing the 24-hour kirtan, they will give you a little prasad of buttermilk. There is a little alcove in the back of the room where there is prasad for buttermilk that they'll give you. So this is the Shripad Samadhi Mandir of Raghunath Das Goswami at Radha Kund. This is again Radha Kund, Shyam Kund. You can see this rectangular one, the one with straight borders is Radha Kund. This Teda Meda one is the Shyam Kund. Shyam Kund is Teda like Krishna. So the reason it is Teda is because when Raghunath Das Goswami was excavating, he had a dream where Pandavas came into his dream, five Pandavas. And they said, we are residing in this place as trees. So there were five trees. They're called Pandava trees. And so please don't cut us because we want to reside here forever. So Raghunath Das Goswami cut around them somehow. And so because of having to cut around them, the Shyam Kund is a little teda like this. This is again Radha Kund, Shyam Kund. They're separated by this place. A lot of people come to take dip. And this is Janva Ma. So Janva Ma, you know, is the consort of Nityanand Prabhu. So this is Sri Janva Mata's sitting place. After Nityanand Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had wrapped up their pastimes from this earth, then Janva Ma actually carried on the Sankirtan movement and was considered a great Acharya at that time. So this is Janva Ma's baithak at Radha Kund. So there are several such sitting places. Yeah, usko gaddi bhi bolte hain, Janva Ma ki gaddi or Mahaprabhu ki gaddi or sitting place ya baithak. So there are several such places in different parts of Govardhan. This is Mahaprabhu ki baithak. This one is at Radha Kund. This is Kramank 9, meaning this is the ninth sitting place of Mahaprabhu. This one is at Radha Kund. And I believe this on the right side, this baithak of Mahaprabhu is at Mansi Ganga. Because he spent a lot of time in Mansi Ganga when he came to Govardhan. And these are the Pandava trees. Not they are not there anymore. There is only one tree left, I think, and that is Yudhishthir Maharaj. So these are the Pandava trees. Okay. So then we go to the next place. Radha Kund has very, very amazing glories. There are songs dedicated to Radha Kund. There are verses. There are pastimes that have happened there. Numerous, numerous pastimes have happened there. There is a very beautiful pastime described in Chaitanya Charitamrita, actually a conversation between Vrinda Devi and Radha Rani, in which Vrinda Devi comes to tell Radha Rani that Krishna is waiting for you at Radha Kund. And she said, why did you go there? She said, I was just going to find you, but I saw that Krishna was doing all kinds of deity worship at Radha Kund. So Radha Rani asked, okay, what was he doing? She said, it looked like he was pehle to he did all kind of aarti and offered incense and flowers and food, and think of all the things that we do for aarti. He did all of those. Then he did a little kirtan. And then he looks like now he's dancing. So the story behind that is that Krishna was trying to please Radharani, because Radharani was very angry with him, and she was not. Whenever she was angry, Krishna would go to please her at Radha Kund, but she was not to be found at Radha Kund. So he started praying to her intensely, just like we do the deity worship. And when he did so much bhajan kirtan, then he started seeing Radharani everywhere. And in the wind of at Radha Kund, he could see that the trees were moving, everything was moving, and everything looked to him like Radharani. ऐसा लग रहा था सब कुछ ही राधा रानी है. ऐसा लग रहा था राधा रानी इज डांसिंग व्हेन ट्रीज वर मूविंग. सो ही आल्सो स्टार्टेड डांसिंग. सो ही वाज इन दिस इल्यूजन दैट राधा रानी इज डांसिंग देयर विद हिम. सो व्हेन राधा रानी हर्ड दैट ओ कृष्णा इज देयर एंड ही इज डूइंग ऑल दिस टू प्लीज हर, शी वेंट टू मीट हिम. सो द कॉन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन वृंदा देवी एंड राधा रानी कम्स इन चैतन्य चरितामृत. वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल कॉन्वर्सेशन. एंड इट्स ऑल अमेजिंग थिंग अबाउट दैट इज दैट इट्स ऑल डिस्क्राइब्ड इन वन वर्स. द होल पास्ट टाइम इज डिस्क्राइब्ड इन वन वर्स. So many other pastimes have happened, Radha Kund. So then there comes the next place, and we are now almost to the end of close to the end of our parikrama, is Kusum Sarovar. So Kusum Sarovar is considered a very, very opulent, if you see, as I bilkul palace-like temples at Kusum Sarovar, very, very opulent place in whole of Govardhan. So very, very beautiful place. This is Kusum Sarovar. You see, so the Kusum Sarovar is the place. So this was Mahaprabhu actually used to call it Suman Sarovar. Why? Because Suman means flower, and at this place, the Radharani and gopis used to pick flowers. So they used to pick flowers to make garlands and other things, and for sun god worship mostly. So in this place, a pastime of one mali pastime happened. So कैसे कुसुम सरोवर आया in manifest हुआ? This is the story that this used to be a garden which was full of many many flowers, different type of flowers, and Radharani and gopis would come and pick flowers from here. And one day when they were picking flowers, Radharani's dupatta got stuck in like the bushes. And when she looked back, she saw this very handsome, tall, moochon wala with mustache, a man standing there. And that person was the one mali, the gardener. And he was holding a big stick in his hand. And when she saw this man, the man helped her to get the dupatta out of the bushes. And he helped her to pick some flowers, some beautiful flowers for sun god worship. So she was very, very attracted by him. She felt like some pulling at her heart just by looking at this one mali. So later on, she told gopis that I felt something very strong attraction towards this one mali. So next day, when they met the one mali again, the one mali said that I want to braid your hair. So he revealed, actually they found out that he's Krishna, and he said, I want to braid Radharani's hair यहाँ पर. तो वहाँ पे वो उनके हेयर ब्रेड करते थे. एंड ही सेड, आई नीड सम वाटर फ्रॉम यमुना टू ब्रेड हर हेयर एंड टू डू हर श्रृंगार. सो ही कॉल्ड यमुना, एंड सो दिस इज वाटर फ्रॉम यमुना बेसिकली. Kusum Sarovar, and this water that he called, he would use this water to braid the hair and to do Shringar of Radharani. And this is the place where they would pick flowers, and that one Mali pastime happened. So and he dug this place with his own hands and called Yamuna, Mother Yamuna, to enter into this area. This is called Kusum Sarovar. In this place, there is another important site called Uddhav Baithak. Uddhav Baithak, you can see the story here. Uddhav Baithak is a place where Uddhav ji actually told the Srimad Bhagavatam to the queens of Dwarka. So when Krishna left this planet, Arjuna took the queens of Dwarka to Vrindavan to safeguard them. He brought them here to Govardhan to safeguard them. And Sri Uddhav ji told them the whole Srimad Bhagavatam here in this place at Kusum Sarovar. And when they heard the Srimad Bhagavatam, after that, the queens were able to go back to Godhead. They actually left this material world and they went back to join Krishna, back to Godhead. So this is the place, it's called Uddhav Baithak, the sitting place of Uddhav ji. And Uddhav deities Uddhav deities are found only in three places. There is a temple here where you can see Uddhav deities. Then there is a temple in Dwarka and of course Badrikashram. So in Braj, in Dwarka and Badrikashram, three places where Uddhav deities can be found. That was Uddhav Baithak. Then this is Narad Kund. Narad Kund is where Narad ji did his tapasya. So when Narad ji came to Govardhan, he wanted entry into Radha Krishna's pastimes. And he went to Shivji. He asked Shivji, ki, how can I get entry into Radha Krishna's pastimes? Please tell me, please enlighten me. I want to enter into their pastime. Shivji said, go to Vrinda Devi. Only Vrinda Devi's mercy can help you enter into Radha Krishna's pastimes. So when he asked Vrinda Devi, she said, do some tapasya here at the Kusum Sarovar. So he did tapasya. So this is all in Kusum Sarovar. The Uddhav ji Baithak is at Kusum Sarovar. The Narad Kund is there also. So he did some tapasya there. And after his tapasya, Vrinda Devi said, okay, now you can go and take a bath in the Kusum Sarovar. He took a bath in the Kusum Sarovar. And when he came out, he had turned into a gopi, which was called Naradi Gopi. And in that form of Naradi Gopi, he was able to enter into the pastimes of Radha Krishna and the gopis. So this is the place where he did that tapasya and entered into Kusum Sarovar. And this is, I think, one of our last ones. This is Gwalpokhar. Gwalpokhar is the place where Krishna used to bring his calves to drink water. And here also many pastimes with his friends have happened, especially with Madhu Mangal. When Madhu Mangal would get, you know, Madhu Mangal is the stocky little friend of Krishna who's a little fat and he likes to eat laddus. So they used to, when one time he got, and he's a Brahmin. So when one time he did some yagya or something for Jatila and Kutila, you know, Jatila and Kutila are the mother-in-law and sister-in-law of Radharani, and they gave him a lot of laddus. And he was coming here, he would come here to eat, and here all the gopas cheated him and somehow stole his laddus. So he got very upset with them. So many, many different pastimes have happened, but this is just a playground of Krishna where he would bring his calves to drink water and play with gopas. So similar, then there is Rudrakund. Rudrakund in Jatipura, there is a town called Jatipura. Jatipura is named after Madhvendrapuri. Pura means town and Jati or Yati means sannyasi. So sannyasi who spent so much time here is called, it was Madhvendrapuri. So after him, this town Jatipura was called. And in this place, there is a kund called Rudrakund. So Rudrakund is the place where Shivji did his tapasya to enter into the pastimes of Radha and Krishna. That is Rudrakund. And this was, I think we've completed our, I mean, there are many other places. There is Panchatirth Kund, very, very opulent and beautiful also, just like Kusum Sarovar. But entry is not allowed these days. And there is a Panchatirth water of five tirthas accumulated in that kunda. Then there is Yugal Kund, so many other places also. And total of about 80 sites that one can see. I did a very, very summarized parikrama. you can see the route, the whole Govardhan that one can take. We start with Mansi Ganga and we came to Kusum Sarovar, and then we can finish at Mansi Ganga again. So this is Mansi Ganga again. We come back to Mansi Ganga again to offer obeisances to the Mukharavind, offer some food and sweets to Tulsi Maharani, and again pray there that we may get residence at Sri Giriraj Govardhan. So this was our complete parikrama. Thank you for letting me present this. It was, I did not have much realizations. I just had read about it and just wanted to share everything that I knew. So I hope you like the parikrama. Sri Haridas Varya Giri Govardhan ki jai.
Hari bol, Mataji. Thank you so much. Actually, this is such a mammoth task that you have such wonderfully of doing, you know, presenting Govardhan Parikrama, that you've so nicely presented and so clearly. Thank you, Mataji. Very, very grateful to you.
Thank you, Mataji. Please share.
That's one. Excellent. Very good.
Thank you, Mataji. You must have many more realizations. Please share. We have some time. If you want to share or add, there must be many things that I missed out and or mistakes that I made. Please share.
No, Mataji, I don't have anything to share or add. You have wonderfully presented. I will open up to other devotees. If they would like to make any comments, questions for Mataji.
So Mataji, I can share that video of Radha Kund that we made. Some of the devotees here have already seen. But if you want, I can share that in the group right now since we have a few minutes. Or I also made a video of Vrindavan Parikrama, just a 5-6 minutes video if you want to see that, either one.
Yes, Mataji, we could do both depending on the time, and you know, we could definitely do both, Mataji.
Okay. Okay, I can show the video of Vrindavan Parikrama. And if we have some time, another 2 days, maybe next week or so, we can Vrindavan Parikrama, we can do in 2 days also, if you're okay. We can do next time, but I'll show the video for now. Can you hear?
Sohe kana kama Good.
Okay, that's all I wanted to share. So maybe a couple days next week or sometime we can do Vrindavan Parikrama. It'll take 2 days at least. Okay, so anybody wants to add or share anything?